Hey everyone, so recently I've been experimenting with a workflow that is probably known to a lot of you guys who are into SubD modeling. It's the TrueStack subdivision workflow. This method is extremely powerful to quickly construct these kind of hard surface shapes. And since it's a non-destructive workflow, it's really easy to control and also keeps the mesh super light. And as you can see, you can achieve quite a lot with this method. And I have been pretty much exploring 80% of this design with this method. So the secret sauce behind this method is to use flat subdivision, which you can find under geometry, dynamic subdiv, and flat subdivision. What flat subdivision does to our model is, it gives subdivision without any smoothing. Meaning, if we now add smooth subdivision on top of our flat subdivision, it will give a mesh where its surface changes are dictated by its single polygons. Therefore, the higher the flat subdivision, the tighter our edges and corners will be, since the flat subdivision acts as supporting edge loops. In addition, we can add thickness to our model, which is also supported by the flat subdivision level. And as a pro tip, if you set the thickness to minus 100, the mesh will be easier to control since the control points for the move brush and the simula brush are staying on top of our surface. Now that we have set up our settings, we can start modeling our shapes. Since this is a subdivision workflow, we are primarily going to use the simula brush and the move brush. Even though the Z-modeler brush comes with options to move vertices and edges, I tend to use the move brush since the control area of vertices is pretty small and quite easy to miss, especially when using subdivision. Now the most important feature we are going to use with the Z-modeler brush is extrude move. With extrude move activated, we can extrude out an edge and introduce a new surface area to our mesh. In addition, we can also activate Snap to Surface and Smart Attraction. While Snap to Surface will snap our extruded edge towards nearby geometry, Smart Attraction will merge two nearby vertices. This is especially useful for retopology. However, I tend to keep these settings off, since building my shapes can be quite annoying when extruded edges jump to random points across the mesh. To connect two edges, therefore, I tend to use Bridge. For insets, mark an area with the Z-modeler brush activated, then switch to Inset, polygroup all, and make sure to use the standard method. Then we can repeat that step by clicking on the same polygroup. After that, let's switch to move, change to polygroup all, and move the insert along its normals. Then we can switch to scale, polygroup all, and polygon center to adjust the falloff of the insert. After that, we can delete those. If we switch to insert, we can hold down Alt and delete unnecessary edges. If you want to flatten out two nearby polys, you can switch to masking, single polys, mask those polys and then invert the mask. Then you can bring out the gizmo and Alt-click on the surface to align your gizmo towards it. Then we can activate local symmetry and scale the two polys along their surface normals. We can also hover over a vertice and switch to stitch, to stitch two vertices to create a triangle if desired. When you're happy with your shapes and want to make further adjustments, you can use my macro Apply Thickness, which is available for free with my latest ZBrush UI on Gumroad. This macro only applies the thickness without applying any of the subdivision. Let's reintroduce smooth subdivision as well as flat subdivision and duplicate our subtool so we can layer some of its part on top. I'm going to use my select lasso to isolate these poly loops, invert my selection and delete hidden. Now I can give this another color and reintroduce thickness. Turn off post subdivision and change the offset to plus 100. Now we are getting this really cool layered effect. To add a bevel effect to our mesh, we can use insert multiple edge loops with interactive elevation activated. Now, when I drag to the left and right, I can change the elevation, and by dragging up and down, I can change the resolution. And just like that, I added some nice bevel effect to the mesh. Now, I can switch to single edge loop and introduce some supporting edge loops to release some surface tension. If you found this helpful, you might also want to check out my new hard surface course for ZBrush. In this immediate to advanced course, I focus on various techniques for efficiently modeling complex meshes using ZBrush's powerful tools. I will cover all the steps from exploring shapes by sculpting with DynaMesh to rebuilding complex forms with ZeroMesher and detailing them with Booleans. This course is perfect for you if you want to elevate your ZBrush hard surface skills to the next level. You can access the course through the link in the description. Until then, guys, take care.